Hello and welcome to a new video from Build with Rafiq. Today, I'm going to show you how to build a basic Bluetooth mesh network using Silicon Labs Thunderboard Sense 2. Before I start with the tutorial, let me show you what the project will look like. In this demo, three Thunderboards are provisioned, two as lights and one as a switch. The lights can be controlled through the Thunderboard that we are using as a switch, or by a smartphone app that can control a group of lights as well as individual lights. Silicon Labs provide the demo software for Bluetooth mesh lighting network. The source code is open source and is available to download. So let's start by building our Bluetooth mesh network. Download and open Silicon Labs IDE Simplicity Studio. Connect the boards to your PC. They would appear on the top left side panel in Simplicity Studio. The first thing we'll need to do is to install the Bluetooth Mesh SDK, which contains the board's demo firmware. You will need to sign up or log in if you already have an account. The login is important so that you'll be granted access to the Bluetooth Mesh SDK. Click on Help followed by Update Software. When the installation manager appears, click on Install by Product Group. Select Bluetooth under Wireless and RF. Follow the rest of the installation by clicking Next and accept the terms and conditions. Now let's choose the first board and flash it with the Bluetooth Mesh Switch demo, which can be found under the Demos tab. For the second board, I'll flash it with the Bluetooth Mesh Light demo. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate a Bluetooth Mesh lighting application for smart home. I used 6 Thunderboards, 4 were flashed with the Bluetooth Mesh Light example and 2 were flashed with the Bluetooth Switch example. The next step is to provision our devices to a network and group them together. For this, you will need to install the Silicon Labs Bluetooth Mesh app on your smartphone, which is available for both iOS and Android. Let's start by creating a new demo. I will name it Demo Smart Home. Click on Done and switch to the Provisioning tab. All the available unprovisioned devices will be displayed here. Before this step, I connected one device at a time, so I can note down each individual board serial number. This will help me arrange them into groups for this demonstration. Let's go ahead and provision the first device. When provisioning a device that is configured as a light, the high brightness LEDs on the board will flash as seen on the far left board. Now let's give it a simpler name. I'll name it Clamp 1. Now I'll go back to the unprovisioned devices list. Select the next board and provision it. This is also a light node, so I will name it Lamp 2. Let's provision a device that is configured as a switch. Select it from the list and provision it. I'll name this one Switch Bedroom. I then repeated this procedure for the other 3 Thunderboards shown on the right. We're almost done. Let's create now 2 groups and add 3 devices in each group. Each group will represent a room for our smart home. I'll name one group bedroom and the other one living room. The final step is to add each device to a group and give it its functionality. Click on the devices tab and select the first lamp. I'll add it to the bedroom group and its function will be light CTL server. CTL stands for Color Tunable Light, which means the device can receive on and off messages, brightness level, and color temperature messages. I'll do the same thing for the second lamp, so let's select it from the devices list. I'll also add it to the bedroom group, and it will have the same functionality as lamp 1. Next, we will configure a switch for our bedroom. So I'll select the bedroom switch and add it to the bedroom group. The switch functionality will also be light CTL, but as a client, so the switch can send messages to the group of lights. I have followed the same procedure for the three other devices, except these were added to the living room group. Now we're good to go and we're ready to test our Bluetooth mesh lighting demo. Under the groups tab, I'll open the bedroom group. If you touch the master control switch, all lights will be switched on or off. Each light device can also be controlled individually. So let's change the color temperature for lamp 1. The lightness level of each device can also be changed. Let's change the color temperature for lamp 2. Now I will test our living room group. Let's switch on all the lights and then make some changes to lamp 3 and 4. The Thunderboard that is provisioned as a switch can also control the light devices. There are two push buttons that can be used to toggle the lights on or off. The light level and color temperature can also be controlled by these two buttons. I hope this tutorial showed you how easy it is to build a Bluetooth mesh network using Silicon Labs Thunderboard Sense 2. Silicon Labs offered the open source SDK for this lighting demo, which you could use as a first step in developing your own smart home applications. For more information, check out the full article in the description of this video.